Terry Zwolan. I'm director of the Cochlear Implant Program at the University of Michigan. I'll be providing a clinician's perspective on sound processor technology. With the Kanso, I love an off-the-ear option for our patients. Initially, when their choices were the Kanso or the N6, a lot of our patients jumped towards the Kanso and were so excited to finally have something that was worn off of their ear. I asked the gentleman, so which one are you going to pick? And he says, do you have any idea how long it's been since I haven't had something on my ear? And I said, no, I don't know. And he said, 40 years, I'm going to get the one that's not on my ear. So he's been very happy with his Kanso. Some of the other things that we really like are the things that these processors do for our patients. One of them is data logging. Once data logging came along, we could find out how honest or even dishonest our patients were about telling us about their device use. So we are able to look at the data log and know how many hours and what kind of situations our patients are using their device in, and we can counsel them about it. Recently, we were able to access a data logging extraction tool, and we were able to look at data logs for more than 6,700 uses of our device since data logging was first introduced in 2013. So we broke it down into adults and children. We had about 170 adult data logs that we looked at during their first year of device use, and we broke them down into a decade of age. So we had from 18 to 30, 30 to 40, 40 to 50, all the way through above 80. And we found that our adults on average use their device about 12 hours a day, so that was great. They're wearing it, they're using it, and 12 hours is a really good number. We did find that our 80-year-olds were using it a little bit less, and they tended to use it in quiet settings, but that's probably typical of what our 80-year-olds are doing during their daily life. But it was important for us to counsel our elderly patients about this. One gentleman that comes to mind, he sat down and I said to him, so about how often are you using your device? And he said, oh, all the time. All the time. So I looked at his data logs and it was about 3 hours. And so I showed him the data logs and I said, whoa, 3 hours, that's not as much as I thought. I thought you said you use it all the time. And he said, yes, all the time when I'm with someone. So I said, well, we're gonna try to get you to use it more than that and not just just all the time when we are with people. There are other ways to be able to understand and learn and increase your device use. So it's been a great tool for us with our adults. In terms of our pediatrics, it's been a great troubleshooting tool and a great counseling tool for our families. I've been doing this for a long time, and patients used to cry at their activations all the time, and that hasn't happened as often. It still happens quite a bit, but what happens now is when we introduce the bilateral or bimodal streaming, patients are so happy that they feel as though they've got great hearing back, they're reconnected with their telephone, they're reconnected with people in their family, they're doing better in school, they're not missing out on things. So the bimodal, bilateral, unilateral streaming is all very good and very helpful for our patients. Some other features are the dual microphone technology and the improved speech recognition and noise. We're seeing those scores go up when we test patients in terms of their speech recognition and noise. And one of my very favorite features is the backwards compatibility. Cochlear has always remembered those N22 users, and they're the first group that I worked with, so they're near and dear to my heart. So it was a great thing to be able to offer them all of the recent technology with streaming capabilities with the N6. And we've got a lot of patients using the N6 who are N22 users who are very, very happy with that technology. So the last feature I'll mention is the Made for iPhone app. I'll be honest, when it first came out, I was a little bit intimidated about it. I got out my note card and helped patients through it. The elderly patients, I'm really surprised. I think the front end is hard, loading the app and registering with Cochlear Family. We help them with that, but once we do all that and we show them the app, it's easy breezy for them. So even our elderly patients are pretty app savvy, at least for the Nucleus Smart app, and they're using their app technology and they're using their devices and they're doing a really great job. The technology is amazing. It's really advancing over time, and I'm always surprised by the new things that come out. You think we've got a great product and it's hard to top, and then a couple of years down the road, something else comes out and tops that one. So personally, I'm really excited about the technology we're going to see coming down the road and how much better it's going to get. I'm kind of jealous of some of the technology that my patients have access to. I want to pick up my phone and have it go right into my ear, and I can't do that. So I think there's going to be some very exciting things that are coming down the road.